So I don't do drop tests on cell phones for multiple reasons. Mostly because in order to get an accurate idea of how well a cell phone does during a drop, you would need multiple cell phones, you know, 5 or 10, and my wallet can't handle that, I'm just one guy. Plus, every drop is a little bit different. Some will drop from, you know, when you're sitting down on your leg and it'll just slide off. Some phones will drop when you pull it out of your pocket and accidentally let it go. It's hard to come up with just one test to cover all the different kinds of drops. But every now and then I'll make an exception, like with the Xiaomi Mi Mix phone that came out about a year ago. That phone was made out of ceramic and I wanted to see how that held up against a drop. This phone, the Essential Phone, is in a similar situation. The back is made out of ceramic, the front is Gorilla Glass 5, and the sides are made out of titanium. So it'll be interesting to see what's damaged first in a drop. So let's see what happens. All right, so in order to do this drop test, I have two cameras set up. I'll have my Essential Phone sitting on my lap right here, and I'll just stand up and let it fall down to the ground, you know, just like a normal everyday drop situation. Then here I have my Galaxy Note 8, which is filming in slow motion. This is the one I took the color off the back, it's clear. And this is my Galaxy S8, which is very scientifically situated on top of this tripod, also filming in slow motion. So here we have the phone. It is in 100% working condition right now. It's kind of bright outside, but you can still see the screen moving. It does have a couple imperfections on it, which is another reason I don't do drop tests, because I've already compromised the integrity of the ceramic panel, as well as the front glass, the Gorilla Glass 5, and the ceramic on the back. You know, the sides have scratches too, but you know, a scratch doesn't compromise metal as much as it does ceramic and glass. I set it on my knee like this. It actually just slides off well enough that we're just gonna leave it like that. So coming from my knee, doesn't look like there's any damage done on the back yet. Oh wow, I did not think that was gonna happen. I thought that the plastic ring around the edge would help the glass not crack. That's way interesting. It still is functioning underneath the glass, so that's good. Another interesting thing is that my scratch marks right here from my Mohs picks are right here and right here. And the crack emanated from over here on the side and down here on the bottom corner. Let's do it again and see if anything happens to the back panel. We'll just let it slide off my leg naturally. Back panel is still fine. If I were to stand up from about pocket height, still nothing on the back panel. The front's just as cracked as it was during that first drop. Waist height with the back facing down. That was a pretty solid drop. And the back is still fine. That's impressive. Screen is just the same as it was on that first drop. That might have just been an extremely unlucky first drop. Let's give it one more shot. Waist height, straight down on the back. So if we're looking at the ceramic, we got the crack in the corner there. It looks like the screen, oh, the screen took some major damage on that last one. The ceramic up here in the top corner looks all right. The plastic is what, you know, that plastic surrounding the lip is what's really damaged. You have my scratch marks, but other than my scratch marks, the ceramic looks pretty undamaged. The back panel's still 100% fine. No scratches besides the ones that I put on it. And the screen is just roasted. It's like we're missing entire chunks of glass out of the front. That's crazy. Since the screen is already broken, we're gonna try it one more time from head height. Right about here, and we'll see if we can get the back ceramic panel to damage. Even from a head height drop, the back panel doesn't do anything on cement. Now the screen's still completely destroyed though. Last time, head height. is still fine. I guess getting a screen protector for this thing would be a good idea, because a screen protector does help the glass hold together, especially in drops. So even though a drop test isn't incredibly scientific, I still think it's super, super interesting. Personally, I thought that the back was going to be the first thing that breaks, since ceramic has a much higher rating on Mohs scale of hardness. It's more brittle. The glass, the Gorilla Glass 5, should have lasted a little bit longer in my opinion, but drops are so hard to predict. Now the good news is that since the back didn't break and the side titanium didn't really damage, the screen is the easiest thing to protect on the whole cell phone. Obviously a case would help an extraordinary amount, but a screen protector would do a lot as well, whether it's the plastic kind of screen protectors or the glass screen protectors. If it were to drop, fall, hit a rock, the first thing that absorbs that impact is the screen protector itself and not the more expensive screen of the phone. So a screen protector and a case are pretty important no matter what cell phone you own. I am going to attempt a teardown of this phone. Even though the replacement parts probably aren't available for it, it'll be interesting to see how the phone is built from the inside and what components can be replaced and what components can't. So hit that subscribe button, hit the thumbs up if you liked this drop test, and if you want me to do more in the future on different phones, not every phone, because like I said, drops are so unpredictable and it's hard to make a scientific test for every single phone without buying like 10 of them. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you around.